Hey guys, welcome to Main Street Live. I'm your host, Bobby Vaughn.
And I'm Teresa Gillis.
Welcome. Well, good afternoon, everybody. It's like snowing out there. One day it's 60 degrees, and the next it's like back to winter. So here we are.
Yes, it's a little cold out there today.
Well, we're going to talk about a couple events we have coming up. Tonight is the Amherst After Hours at the Brew Kettle from 5 to 7.
It is.
And what goes on there, Teresa?
Nothing, absolutely not. Actually, it's a great way to network. It's a great way to get to know their business owners and what they have to sell. And you may learn some things from the businesses. It's just a way, like if someone were to come into your business and you don't have what they're looking for, you might be able to direct them to another business that has that product. And this is the first year that we're going to the Brew Kettle in downtown Amherst. So we'd like everybody to come out and check out. They've done a really nice job over there.
Yes. And then our next thing is the Amherst Comedy Night, which is Saturday, February 24th.
It is.
And what's going on there?
We are going to have three comics. We're really excited about it. It is the second
I'm not
year.
One of them. Either.
No. We have three comics, and Bob Slatt, who ran the event for us last year, is going to do it again. So we're really excited about having him back. And then we have a couple other comics, and he's looking for a fourth one. But it will be held at the Amherst Cinema. And I know that last week we mentioned that you can buy tickets online. You still can. You can go to the mainstreetamherst.org, but the link wasn't working last week. So we got that fixed, and so you can go to the link and you can buy your tickets right on there.
And you can also go to participating retail locations.
Absolutely.
Like Etcetera, Sandstone Cattle Works, Monteriors, and Old Town Pizza.
Yeah. So, you know, buy your tickets. We're only selling 300. They'll go quickly, and it'll be a fun event, and it's $30. And you get lots of laughter, you get a drink, and the drink is alcohol, or it's water, or it's soda. It can be either one, or either of the three. And then you get a popcorn with that as well.
So. Yeah, I would tell a joke right now, it's about pizza, but it's really cheesy, so I don't know. No, it's be much funnier than that, guys. So come on out and support it.
Yeah.
And also you can be involved as far as any of our committees that we have going on, such as Comedy Night. We'd like to hear your input, any information, any ideas you have.
I'm really excited because Ginny from Anytime Fitness is co-chairing this event. She's not on the board, so we're really glad to have her. And we also have Ryan Ladd from Mercy Rec Center, who is also has volunteered to chair one of our events. So that's exactly what we're looking for. We're looking for people that want to be involved and help us chair. We won't just throw it at you and you're all on your own, but we'll be there to help you along the way. We have a binder for each event. So, so it's going to be a lot of fun, good, interesting year.
All right. Well, today we are at the Amherst Public Library.
We are.
It's very cool. Yeah, they did a lot of remodeling. And today we are with Becky Dennis from the Amherst Public Library.
So
let's come over here.
Hello. Hello.
Welcome. We're glad to have you.
Thank you.
Glad to be with us today.
Yeah, thanks for the invite.
Yeah, so we thought maybe you could tell some of the viewers, what is happening in the library. I don't think that people realize all the things that happen here.
We have a ton of stuff coming up. The big thing we have starting on Monday is adult winter reading. And this year we're changing it up a little bit. You, of course, read any book you want, and you complete this entry form. But this year you can also watch a movie based on a book.
Oh, wow.
So if you watch Shawshank Redemption, you can complete one of these.
Nice.
Or if you go see one of the new ones coming out in the theater, like there's, I'm not sure if Ready Player One will be out in time, but there's tons of movies.
Mm-hmm.
We have a few listed right here. So we've got some coming out that'll be out in February. We'll be out towards the end of this month. You can go see any of those, fill out a form, and you get a small prize.
Oh, nice.
We have little director clapper keychains. It's a little one of these with a photo frame.
Mm-hmm.
We also have little plastic cups, clips, and of course we have pens because we always have pens for winter or summer reading.
Well, that's perfect.
You gotta have
it's
pens.
It's Oscar season. Oscars are coming.
Exactly, and that's all actually tied into winter reading this year. We're also going to have a weekly trivia contest that involves an Oscar-winning movie.
Oh, nice.
And every week you'll be able to enter the trivia contest, and the prize is a DVD copy of that movie. And then we'll also be having an Oscar predictions contest.
Very nice.
And that'll start on February 12th.
Do they have to come and sign up here?
You don't have to sign up for winter reading. You just come in and pick up some slips. They're going to look just like this. We'll have some upstairs and downstairs.
Okay.
You can also take a look at our nice little selected titles brochure here to get some idea of different, books on movies.
Right.
Movies on books.
Yeah.
And so I'll give you an idea, and then you would come in to do the trivia.
Mm-hmm.
And you can come in and pick up, starting on February 12th, the Oscar predictions.
Okay. I am always horrible with my Oscar predictions, because I don't ever see any other movies.
But see, and a lot of it's just educative guessing.
Yes, that's right.
So this runs, begins again January 29th on Monday, as soon as we open, and it's going to run through March 5th.
Can we believe it's the end of January?
I know.
I can't even believe it.
And that's just the big thing. We've got other stuff going on.
What else do you
have? We have crochet classes coming back with Vivian Rutherford.
So
those are very popular.
Is it beginner?
It's beginner. It's all levels.
Okay.
So if you're a beginner, you come in, you bring a J crochet hook and a skein of sugar and cream yarn, and she'll show you how to make a washcloth. If you're already working on a project or you're more intermediate or advanced, you just bring whatever you want to work on. And it's kind of like, it's a nice little community thing.
Yeah,
that's
nice.
It's in this room. Almost all of our programming takes place in this room, whether it's the story times that we have weekly.
Okay.
We actually just had story times this morning. We have two on Wednesday mornings for waddlers, which are basically under two. And then for more preschool age, we also have those on Monday and Tuesdays.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, story times
are
great.
It's a beautiful room, too.
Yeah, it's a fantastic space. And as you can tell, the acoustics in here are fantastic.
Yes.
We've had music performances here. We've had speakers. We do all kinds of things.
Nice.
We have yoga here. We actually have our last yoga for the month this Thursday, tomorrow. And that's going to be with Rob Schulman. It's suitable for all experience levels, and he does adapt a chair for people with mobility issues.
So does that cost?
There is no cost for any of our programming.
Wow,
that's really nice.
We never charge for any of our programming. We also have coming up on the same day that winter reading starts, on Monday, we have a health device demo with the Northeast Ohio Regional Library System.
Nice.
So they're going to be showing us how to use like TempTrack, which is a body temperature monitor, and just basically different health devices, blood pressure cuffs and things like that.
So let me ask you this.
Yeah.
Just asking questions so the viewers can know.
No.
So if I wanted to participate in any of the things you have, do I have to have a library card?
No. You don't have to have a library card. Most of our programs don't require even registering.
Okay.
You can just come. If it does require registration, we make sure we note that on the calendar.
Okay.
We do have one coming up on the 5th with the Luray County Board of Mental Health. It's going to be about suicide prevention, how to recognize the signs, and how to work with people to prevent it and help them find help.
Nice.
And that's going to be Monday. It's Monday, February 5th at 6:30. That does require registration. You can register online on our website, or you can call in and register with the reference desk.
Okay, nice.
Mm-hmm. Another question, too, is for all these programs, obviously you have a website. You see
right.
You can go to that. What is that?
Yes. It's just AmherstPublicLibrary.org.
Okay.
Oh, that's good to know. Mm-hmm. I thought it was a tricky website, actually.
No. It's just AmherstPublicLibrary.org, and you can view our calendar from there.
Okay.
So you can register for programs on the website. You can also check out all of the other stuff we have, because we don't just have the books here. You know, we have access to all these databases that I don't think people quite realize. You can look up academic articles through them. You can look up legal things through them.
And you have, did you say you have computers and stuff here?
We have public use computers.
Yeah,
so you only have so long to use those per day?
Kind of. There's an hour limit.
Okay.
And then basically as long as nobody's waiting, they get refreshed every half hour.
Okay.
So we'll have people that'll come in and they'll be working on an online class and they'll be here for 2-3 hours.
Mm-hmm.
But of course when we get really busy, it's not a good time to do it. So basically, in the afternoon, it gets a little iffy because school comes out and we get pretty full up. So if you really need to use a computer and you're going to use it for a while, it's best to come in before 2 or after 5.
So what are your days and hours?
We are open every day until Memorial Day. We'll start being closed on Sundays for the summer.
Okay.
But right now, we're open every day. And Monday through Thursday, we're open from 9 to 8:30. Friday and Saturday, we're open from 10 to 5.
Okay.
And on Sundays, we are open from 1 to 5.
Wow, that's really nice. Very nice.
So we're here every day, like I said, but just keep in mind, once summer hits, we won't be here on Sundays.
Sundays, okay. I just like to encourage everybody to go to their website and check it out, because there's a lot of things that they offer that I don't believe people even realize.
Yeah,
we
offer a lot of e-books.
Okay.
So we have e-books, e-audio, you can stream music through a Hoopla app. You use Overdrive in the Ohio Digital Library to read ebooks.
Mm-hmm.
So there's all the stuff that's available. It's pretty great.
Another way to find out what they have to offer is the Main Street meetings are the first Thursday of every month at 9 a.m. in the Main Street building. But Char, who works here at the library, comes and she mentions a lot of things that are happening. So come to the Main Street meeting, because that too, Mike wants to say something behind the camera.
There was a comment online, somebody wants to know if the event on February 5th is adults only or children, young adults can come.
I would say that it would be ages like 14, 15 and up, because it is such a sensitive topic. You're not going to want to bring a younger child to it.
That's a good point. Great question.
We do have something coming up that will be for the whole family on February 18th. We're having a family bingo day.
Oh.
So we're going to have it. It'll be down here. And we'll have a bingo set up here. And then we're also going to have a special game for children under 10 set up in our local history room.
So for bingo, do they have to bring anything with them?
They don't have to bring anything with them. Everything's provided. We have the cards and the bingo chips. It's awesome. And there are going to be small prizes and bragging rights awarded to all the players.
Oh, nice. I think we may have to come to that.
Yeah, that's
our Main Street family.
Exactly. It doesn't. Family is anything. It doesn't.
Right.
It's not just your typical, you know, parents and kids. Anybody is welcome. And
Johnny's bingo.
That's going to be on Sunday, February 18th, from 2:30 to 4.
Okay.
And they said that'll be right down here, because everything is right down here.
Right. That's really nice. It's a great facility, and they just redid the whole upstairs. So anybody that hasn't been here to see the upstairs and the renovation, you really should come down.
Oh, yeah, anybody who hasn't been here in the last year, every time they come up, they're just wide-eyed looking around.
it's beautiful up here.
Well, thanks so much.
Oh, you're very welcome.
We appreciate you being with us today.
Very welcome.
We hope everybody stays warm. Yes.
Can I just add one more thing? Make sure people, if you come in, you grab one of our calendars.
Oh, yes.
We're actually doing a little bit of a changeover for them starting for February. We're going to have one calendar for adults and children instead of two separate ones. And then when you turn it over, there's a nice little brief blurb about every program we have.
That's nice to have.
Yes.
That's
so really you won't even have to go online for this. You can just pick up the calendar here and take a look. It's all right here.
Very nice.
So, and these will be available within the next couple days.
Okay. And I'd like to have some of those at Main Street. So if anybody
wants absolutely.
To
yeah, we can send
pick
that
one
to
up
you.
To that'd be awesome.
Yeah, that'd be fantastic.
Well, all right, guys. Well, stay warm out there, and we'll see everybody next week.
Yeah, thank you for joining us. Have a great day.